you know, we need some motivation, some success tips that, you know, that help us keep going in life. And definitely this session would have definitely helped us, you know, having a growth mindset. So thank you so much, Kalyani ma'am,
for attending.
I would like Pujan Parekh to give a vote of thanks.
Before the vote of thanks, we have 2 to 3 questions. But then if you want, we can take them, or we will keep it for the next session.
So I am very much available right now to take up questions because, okay, so we have 4 questions. Okay.
Okay, so I'll be reading it for you.
Yeah, read the questions best.
Okay. Akansha says, how to stay motivated when you're facing continuous failures while aiming for success?
Okay. So one of the ways you can make sure that you continuously stay motivated is by focusing on your goals. And the continuous failures could be happening because of a certain belief system. So make sure you work on your beliefs. Who has asked this question?
Akansha Gautam. Can you unmute her?
Akansha. Okay, what you can
Akansha
do.
Akansha Singh Gautam.
Okay. Akansha, take my number. Okay. Because see, what happens is when you are continuously failing, getting failure, which means there is something about your belief system that is coming in the way and which has kind of created a pattern. But one of the ways to always be motivated is to have realistic goals and keep focusing on the goals. So if you need more help on that, get in touch with me. I've just put my phone number on the chat box for you. Next question.
Next question is from Karan Shah. There are times when we know that we have learned from our failures, but also the subconscious mind is not able to accept that. How should some overcome the same? Okay. I would just read. Did you understand, or I should read
yes,
it again?
Yes, I understood. Okay.
Okay.
Now, in order for your subconscious mind to accept what you have learned from your failure, I have sent you all affirmations. So affirmation is a very, very powerful tool to program your subconscious mind. Okay. Simply keep repeating to yourself that I have learned from this situation. In fact, don't even call that situation a failure. Okay. You can just call it an experience. Just call it a situation. The moment you call it that, it becomes a very neutral experience. And tonight before you go to sleep, you know what I want you to do? Just make a list of things that you learned from that experience. Look at it, read it, and go off to sleep. Believe me, that goes in your subconscious mind. So 10 minutes before you go off to sleep, 10 to 15 minutes before you go off to sleep, and 10 to 15 minutes once on waking up is a very powerful time to program your subconscious mind, because that time your subconscious mind is active. The conscious layer barrier has gone. So you're very receptive to suggestion. So do this technique that I have told you. Just write it down, read it, and go off to sleep reading that. Secondly, you can do affirmations on power, strength, and confidence. I've already shared with you 50 powerful affirmations. Other than that, you can do visualization techniques. And rather than focusing on the past failures, focus on the future success. Are you getting it? So see, I showed you the focus. You remember the activity. You can focus on only one thing at a time. Are you getting it? The moment you start focusing on your future success, the past gets deleted. That's how our brain functions, okay? Our brain functions with deletion, distortion, and generalization. And that's what our brain is doing all the time. And we can only focus on one thing at a time. So you're either focusing on the past failures or you're focusing on your future success, okay? So do these simple techniques and I think that should help you. Next question.
Next question is from Palomi. It is, how to avoid negative vibes affecting you?
How to avoid, okay, negative vibes. All right. So first of all, if they are, obviously they are from people, if you can avoid the people, brilliant. Okay. If you can avoid the people, brilliant. And for all of you in this group, remember one thing, you are an average of 5 people you spend most of your time with. Okay. It's scientifically proven. And in leadership classes, we teach this, that you are an average of 5 people you spend most of your time with. So number one, if you can avoid and ignore this person, delete this person from your life, it's fantastic. Number two, if you can't, then learn to ignore. And how you learn to ignore is you make yourself mentally strong. you make yourself a more positive person so that the negative vibes don't affect you. You know, like for the coronavirus, the best thing you can do is strengthen your own immune system. So that's what you can do to strengthen your own immune system. The other ways you can avoid negative vibes is, so a spiritual way of doing it is, whenever you feel you've been affected with a lot of negativity, just have a khada namak salt water bath. It's very powerful. It is a scientific technique because salt chemically absorbs all the negativity. And spiritually also, it's a very powerful technique. Whenever you feel that you're in a lot of stress and, you know, somebody said something to you, and, you know, sometimes you just feel that there's some energy hanging on us. You feel a little heavy. So that time, just dip your legs in a warm salt water bath, throw that water, and then put salt water in your bathing water. Take a bath with it. Okay, but don't put it on your hair, dandruff ho jayega. Okay, just on your body. It's very, very powerful. Give you a calm sleep. And yes, that's what you do it. And focus on being more positive. Focus on your more happiness. And one more thing, you know, don't give other people so much of importance. One question I ask is, do they pay my bills? So, it's a funny question. But if someone's opinion is affecting me, I just ask myself, hey, do they pay my bills? So I say no, then they don't matter. Then they don't matter. Okay, so that's one fun thing you could do. I hope that has helped you. All right, next question.
Next question is from Chintan. Any tips on focus management? I start with one thing, then go on something else unknowingly, and both of it is incomplete. So
yes,
he's asking for suggestions.
Okay, so Chintan, there are two types of things. Okay, remember, all of you, now this is for all of you, and thank you for these questions because everyone gets to learn so much. There are two types of activities you will do throughout the day. Okay, one activity is the activity which requires very, very high level of focus. So for example, when I write my books, it requires high level of focus. When I'm conducting a session, seminar, it requires high level of focus. Then there are other activities which you can multitask. Like for example, every evening I take a half an hour walk, and that's the time I'm watching Netflix, I'm watching some videos. So you're getting it. So if your activity is a high focus activity, here's what you can do. There is, write this down. Okay, I'm putting in the chat box. There's a technique called as the Pomodoro technique. And it's actually for people like you and me who are very hyperactive. So it's called as a Pomodoro technique. And this technique is, it's a scientifically proven technique. 20 minutes, average human attention span is 20 minutes. Okay, so you have to do a deal with your mind. Chintan, you have to do a deal with your mind. Okay, beta. 20 minutes, give me your full focus. 20 minutes ke baad, main 10 minutes ka break lunga, and that's the time I will enjoy. And typically, distraction, social media or phone se hi hota hai. So for 20 minutes, just keep your phone away, fully focus, and then 10 minutes, take a break. And in that break, do an activity you enjoy. Then again, come back. Again, do a 20 minute and again, take a 10 minute break. Okay, now the 10 minute break should not exceed. It's a very powerful technique, especially if anyone is studying for competitive exams, 12th standard, 10th standard. And this is how even I am able to focus, because I'm quite hyperactive. So I do have these challenges. Now, believe me, one skill you can all learn is to learn to practice your focus. So one yoga technique you can do is candle ko jalao, ek distance pe rakho. Okay, so let's say this is a candle, and just keep it at a distance, like a hand's distance. Light it up, okay? Don't hold it in your hand. Light it up, put it on a table somewhere. Sit and focus on the tip of the candle, the flickering candle flame. Okay, it's a yoga technique. It's also known as candle meditation. Increases your confidence. If the Agni element in you less, which means if confidence is less, if passion is less, then it ignites the fire in you, and it helps in concentration also. So start with 1 minute of focus challenge, Chintan. Then do a 2 minute focus challenge. Then do a 3 minute focus challenge. Focus on that flame. Eventually, my dear, you will notice that your focus has increased to 5 minutes, 10 minutes without you even realizing. So yeah, it's definitely possible to put in high focus. Also, because jab hum high focus dete hai na, hamara efficiency badhta hai, and the quality of work that you do increases. Okay. सो सिंपल टेक्निक यू कैन डू. पोमोडोरो टेक्निक का ऐप भी आता है बाय द वे. यू कैन सेट एन ऐप, यू कैन पुट एन अलार्म एंड इट रिमाइंड्स यू. सो देयर इज अ पोमोडोरो ऐप आल्सो अवेलेबल. एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस?
We are done with the questions. Actually, I would like to say one thing. Huh. That is, a good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, and a great teacher inspires. And thank you for being the great teacher today.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much.
Over to Pujan for vote of thanks.
Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Firstly, I hope this webinar has been fruitful for all of you. The webinar is over, but as per Kalyani ma'am's instructions, we know we have to work on this continuously. So the real work starts now. Secondly, thank you, Kalyani ma'am, for giving us your precious time. We definitely look forward towards more sessions from your end. Thanking our MDP, Leo Manthan Mehta, Leo Nupen Gandhi, and Leo Hemant for the efforts they've put into to gather almost 70 participants. Also, the efforts of Leo Janice and Leo Herschel, because of whom we finally conceptualized what we are going to do throughout this year. And last but not the least, a big thanks to all you participants for attending this webinar. I hope all the participants are following us on our social media handles so that you all don't miss out on more such topics. We will be forwarding links of our social media accounts on the WhatsApp group, so kindly don't leave it. Also, tell us, I would want you guys to tell us what topics you all want to us to cover in the future webinars. We are also going to share a Google feedback form, so kindly fill it. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. I am here for some more time if anyone has questions. If anyone has questions, you can ask me. Thank you, everyone. So looks like everyone wants to sleep. Thank you, Palomi. Thank you, Krishar. So I'm reading the chats now because I can, it's difficult for me. Thank you. Thank you, Devansh. Thank you, Jeel. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Krisha. Thank you, Pujan. Thank you, Jainish. Thank you, Mallikarjun. Super. So thank you, everyone. Good night. Sleep well. Make sure you do the mental. For success tonight. Thank you. Bye-bye.